that there is this famous black hole thermal radiation. So there are situations are so extreme that so many particles and so the gravitational effects have so much power that we are not in a ground state but in a thermal state. And famous Hawking radiation says that on the black hole horizon you feel on the external of the black hole you feel a radiation. It's very small, but you feel that. Another possible aspect would be early universe. Maybe it's not in thermal equilibrium, but okay, conceptually this is also good. From the mathematical viewpoint, at least my personal personal motivation, the way I started, was the search for the quantum field theory index theorem. The famous Atiyah-Singer index theorem is supposed to have a infinite dimensional version, so where maybe elliptic operator will become the sectors, and the idea, the Fredholm index, the Jones index. Mm-hmm. This is a long story that is moving slowly because there are not technical difficulties, but also conceptual things that we have to know, but it's moving. And of course, we had in the past that is this supersymmetric JL, JFE, Lesniewski-Ostwald cocycle that gives the other candidates. So in this sense, more super KMS than KMS should be relevant, but we should start with KMS to understand KMS. Okay, this is the general motivation. Now, let's look at what at conformal field theory. Conformal field theory is certainly the place of quantum field theory where mathematics is most successful. And operator algebra is the most successful in particular. So with operator algebra, it seems that we have all we can govern all the structure. And in fact, we can also see things that other approaches don't see. So it is extremely a successful way. So let me take a minute to write the KMS condition, not because I know that you know the KMS condition, but because maybe at some point we should share some comments on that. So we have a sister algebra A, a one-parameter automorphism group, dynamical system, and then KMS condition that two things that you have a state phi is KMS. Is if for all x and y in A, there exists a function x, y, that's which is analytic bound in the strip in C less than beta n 0, bounded on the closure. Such that f x y of x alpha t y is f t and phi of alpha t y x is f x t plus I beta. So there. It's like a trace, we have to go to the boundary of a state to exchange the values under the states. Conformal nets. Or local conformal nets. Fortunately, James has already introduced, and others have already introduced the concepts. So there are two pictures. Circle S1. So for every int interval of the circle, we get a Neumann algebra on some fixed Hilbert space with a locality, which means that the commutation for the joint interval and Möbius covariance, vacuum vector, and positive Auger energy. Oh, you may stop any moment. Positivity of the energy means that in this picture that the conformal Hamiltonian, so the generator of rotation, is positive. And then there is the circle, the line picture, which is for every interval of the real line. We have for Neumann algebra. Similar things, except that here we refer to things that don't move the point at infinity. The two are related by, if you have something on the circle, we have the stereographic projection. So an interval is an interval here on the circle. These two are the same circle. Now, usually, we also assume a diffeomorphism covariance. So the Möbius symmetry extends to a projective unity representation of the diffeomorphism group. Now, general theorem is that now from the circle, it's clear how to go to the real line, but how do we go from the real line to the circle? Of course, we go to the real line to the point of the circle. So if I have a net on the real line, how do I decide that it comes from the net to the circle? And the question is that A on R comes from A on S1 if and only if translation and dilation covariant and dilation is KMS at 10 inverse at the beta equal to pi or minus pi if you want to for A of 0 infinity. So if we are on the circle, there is a general theorem that we can compute the modular group of every interval. Any is equivalent to the other because Möbius group acts covariantly, so we can compute the modular group of this. And in the real picture, that will be the dilation. If we have this property, this we can extend. This is not here. It comes from to prove this was not the reason, but it came from the Weisbrock theorem, Araki Weisbrock theorem, which says the following: the number of theorem. Suppose n m are Neumann algebras. Omega cyclic and separating vector for n, m, and the relative commutant, and outside the modular condition, so delta n minus T M delta M minus IT is contained in N for T greater than 0. Then N M extends to a conformal net S1. So in what I'm saying, we can take, for example, this is a large Conformal algebra, this is smaller, and then what is the modular group we generate. So this is a by.
Is that minus minus?
Yeah, this is a plus. Oh, okay. That's a. Now, let's say in the line pitch. Take A, the sister algebra, union of AI, closure in the null topology. And the question is, what are the KMS states on A with respect to translation? First, an old result by Takesaki and Wiener implies that these states are locally normal. If you stick to the state to every, in a state to every local algebra, it's normal. Automatically locally normal. Okay, so the first thing is. If we are in a conformal case, what are the beta, I should say, in a state at a certain temperature, but this temperature is not at all relevant because we have dilation. So if you have a state and we use dilation to change the temperature, so we can fix the temperature, and then if we know it's one temperature, we know the other. So the first observation is that there is always a canonical state, the geometric state. KMS states. This work, there are two papers by Camassa, Wiener, Tanimoto. What is this a geometric KMS state? It's a following. So we are on the real line. Okay. And we know that on the positive real line, there is a KMS state, which is the vacuum. The vacuum is restricted with dilation. But with the logarithm, we can then take, we can take R into R plus by exponential method. So we can transform all the real line in the here, and then translation will go to dilation. This is, of course, not a diffeomorphism, but locally it is a diffeomorphism. So it is well-defined map at the level of this sister algebra, in the sense that if I want to send this interval, that will go to, let's say, to this interval. So I to AB to EA EB. Then I can use any very diffeomorphism that makes the job. I don't care what it does otherwise. But it's a well-defined map. So it's a level of sister log inductive limit of Conformal algebra. It's well-defined. So I can transform the real line here. And then I can send, with this map, I transform phi into the vacuum. So the back, this will be at beta, of course, 2 pi or minus 2 pi, that depends on how you normalize that. So this is, of course, it's always there. It's a KMS state, which is distinguished from all the others. And And now the question is that what are the other KMS states? Are there? Let me call the notion that complete rationality. A is completely rational if the new index is finite, is a Kawagashi and mu girl, where mu index is just the index you split. Here, I1, I2, I3, and I4. Then you look at the index of I1. This gives by the recent results that I mentioned by Wiener that this satisfies the split property, but it also satisfies a strong additivity. So completely rational. Implies strong additivity. Namely, half duality on the real line. This Feng Shu and myself. This was the, so if you on the real line, if you take the complement of an interval, the phenomenon, and take the commutant, then you get the phenomenon. Okay, the first main result I want to tell you is that for completely rational, this is the only KMS state. If A is completely rational, then the geometric state at temperature 2 pi is the only. On the other hand, if A is not completely rational, there might be uncomfortable. Now let me give a hint how this follows. The question is the following. So we start with our KMS state. With our this is our initial conformal net. And phi is KMS state. Then we look at this inclusion. A of R, let's say in the GNS representation, that contains phi of A0 infinity. And this is satisfies the hypothesis of the whisper theorem, because in the GNS representation, translation is a modular group, it's KMS. So it is outside modular inclusion. So we get another conformal net, no? So this gives, let's say, another conformal net. Let's say B, the thermal completion. And then you ask when the thermal completion is the original net. And B reproduces, is isomorphic to the original net, if and only if B is strongly additive. So, so it's it's relatively, so the question is the following. Question is the following. So in the, we have this net I, and then we take an interval. And we compare with the phenomenal algebra of the same interval minus 1 point. So we remove 1 point. And we are interested in the fact whether these two phenomenal algebra coincide. If we start with the complete irrational case, this is a limit case where we remove an interval. So the mu index, the index will be finite, but not zero. But then, so if when we start with a completely rational, so AD, ABD, this is the index is finite. But then, if the index is finite, we have this situation which looks a bit strange, that we have the failure of actuality on the real line up to finite index. We use this Weisbrock theorem and to get a new net with a full actuality by replacing this phenomenal algebra by this. And then we take the conformal completion again. And then there is an argument that this process must stop somewhere because of finite index. And then when they stop, should coincide, you go again, and that's the proof. So it's a very indirect proof. But the index theory is essential. Now we can compute. So that's an example. Yuasuronet. It's you take the irreducible representation of irreducible positive energy of diffeomorphism OS1, which central charge is projected with central charge C, and lowest weight 0. And then you define the algebra A of I. With the G is a diffeomorphism such that in the complement of I is the identity, double complement. This will be the Dirac-Sor net with central charge C. And then with C less than 1, it's completely rational. So only one KMS states. For C equal 1, it's not completely rational. And but it has some finite sector. But we can evaluate, I will write you the formula for you, of the possible, but with some comment. So take the stress energy tensor we have this this formula. So for every Q is a line. So that these are the formula of the KMS states that we know, the geometric state correspond to Q equal to zero. Q geometric states is Q equal to 1 over beta 5 C minus 1 6. These are all the KMS states for C less than 1 and for at C equal also at C equal 1. And for C larger than 1, we don't know. But it's very likely. So heuristically, they are all, but we don't know. And but this Q is comes from the following, because we can embed the VSO net for sent charge larger than 1 into U1 current algebra, not as a subnet, as a circle, but a subnet in the real line. And then we can compute the KMS states on the U1 current algebra. These are all. So by restriction, we get this. So this is a sort of chemical potential. I will not say more on this. But so we have a rather good understanding in the basic models, and enough to treat to make calculation when we have to evaluate the KMS states on the stress energy tensor, or if we have some chemical potential. If I have time, I will explain what we can do. Now, the case, the circle picture. So we have net on A on S1. And the first thing to decide what is a sister algebra, because it's not an inductive limit. No? The first proposal, there was some confusion in the literature. Also, this universal sister algebra is something that you embed all algebras here, such that every representation, row, on UH extend to a representation is universal. This may be defined by abstract nonsense. No? So the unique sister algebra, which has this property. More concretely, what you can do, you take the direct sum of all representation, possible representation, and you take a closure. So it's like for groups. You know, you can define the group sister algebra just by maximal sister norm or just by the regular representation. I am going to comment on that. But before that, there is another difficulty that taking the direct sum of all representations is not possible because that is not a set. No? So we have to take cyclic representation states and okay. Normal, yes, so it's better to take the only locally normal representation. Okay. Although with the split property on a separate Weber space, all representation will be locally normal. But let's say we are in the, we take only the normal. Then this is a sister algebra with rotation acts. One colleague in a string theory recently asked your Tanimoto and me, he wrote to us and asked what are the KMS states for rotation. Apparently, they are interested for certain reason. understand correctly for this ADS CFT correspondence and so on. So we wanted to work out, no? After a moment of reflection, we saw that in the completely rational case, the answer is now rather easy because of a result of Carpi, Conti, Wiener. This is a sister algebra. No? It contains Conformal algebra, but it is truly a sister algebra. It's not a Conformal algebra. No? It doesn't live on Hilbert space. But they showed that if A is completely rational, then A in a universal algebra is direct sum of finitely many type 1 functors. It's isomorphic to this. So it is a Conformal algebra, which is, I couldn't believe when I saw this result at first sight. There is no reason why this should be a Conformal algebra. It comes from this simple exercise that if you are on a Hilbert space, which is just tensor product of 3, okay, not in the vacuum, it's more complicated, I will comment, but in the vacuum, you make this simple exercise, and then you take the algebra generated by VH1 to tensor 1 and 1 tensor VH2 tensor H2. Just the algebra, the star algebra generated by this is VOH. Okay. And by the split property, you play this gamma, and you are done. So this is a powerful result. So this, what are these components? These are the sectors. So the representation, the locally normalized, just means that you cut down by central projection. And so we can classify easily the every. So KMS states correspond sector, irreducible sector, and that of the form phi of x will be just placed in the sector E minus the conformal Hamiltonian in the sector of the log of x. So it's a very easy. And now what is the general? Now what are in the non-computation case? The situation is the same by using different proof, but of course in the non-completely rational case, we cannot use this powerful result. Non-rational case, same result, but we have to assume something, at least for the moment, assuming that lowest weight distinguish sectors. So we should not have two representations, reducible representation with the same lowest weight. It is not true. What we really need that for the same lowest weight, we should have at least countably many representations, but not the continuum. Otherwise, there might be counterexample. We don't have a counterexample. What is a possible counterexample if it exists? It will be a Gibbs state in the representation, like here, but in a type 2 infinite factor. So there might be some 2 infinity representation. It is a trace, but we have no example. No? It is an open question. But apart from this, course, in a almost all interesting case, we can apply this, and so we can compute the KMS states. And now, I want to give I want to explain very briefly how we can use the results. I plan to give other talks in different places, and I plan to devote next talk on this new work with Stefan Hollands. So this is, I think, the first approach to non-equilibrium thermodynamics with the conformal field theory. So what is non-equilibrium thermodynamics? Non-equilibrium thermodynamics is, well, first of all, it's something which is in evolution. It's not like thermodynamics, which is well established. But it won't describe a situation where there is no equilibrium, but we are close to equilibrium, in the sense that with the concept of the thermodynamics, we can explain. Huh? Typical situation is the following. We split our space in two parts. Here there is a reservoir, one at temperature, let's say, inverse temperature, beta L. And one is, this is also in equilibrium, at another temperature. They are separate. Then we remove the wall. If they are infinite, like the sea, there is a flux from the, so from where we have a more higher temperature to lower temperature, but it stabilizes. No? And this is a typical situation that wants to establish statistical mechanics. So what are the relevant states? They are not the KMS states. So a class of important states is a non-equilibrium steady states. Non-equilibrium. These are the following. Well, if you remember, I wrote the definition of KMS states. It had two parts. One of the this analytic function, and the other one that B was the equality at the boundary. No, that one. Then we keep only this part. So this function should be an analytic extension bounded in the strip for a dense set. It's a non-equilibrium steady state. How to construct a simple example? Take the tensor product of two systems at different temperatures. Then, of course, for monomials, no, you get this property. No? And Ruel proposed that this to satisfy. And now, what we do, let's go to conformal field theory. Pardon?
I didn't understand the property.
The definition?
Yes.
Okay. If this one extends to a bounded holomorphic function in a strip, this strip is independent of x and y for a dense set. So in the case of a tensor product system, you just take the algebraic tensor product without completion. This is a maybe I have time to recall another key concept. But, relativistic.
Okay, in this condition. Rows and Buchholz.
Rows and Buchholz start to work because in quantum field theory, we have Lorentz symmetry, Poincaré symmetry, so there is no privileged time axis, no? You can modify by Lorentz transformation. So you cannot define KMS condition with time translation, but it should be independent. So they define, I will be very briefly. So instead of considering privileged time transformation, let's say we take a unit time-like vector, you take the double cron span, and we want that this function f p of x alpha t of y, this should extend, well, x so in space and time should extend to an analytic function in this region, and with some, and the exchange with the f. And f of x okay in this point will be just so the KMS condition is appear along this line, if you want, but we have an analytic extension. You know, that's roughly explained this. And this, of course, independent, because if you apply Lorentz transformation, we change the vector, but the condition itself remains. And then here, relativistic KMS condition holds in CFT. When it holds for the geometric and much more generality. Much more generality means that if one worked, one could prove for all, I would think, but we didn't work out. But in the sense that one has to pass from finite index to infinite index, but there is no conceptual difference. No? But for the moment, we are glad with this. Should I read it for you? the relativistic KMS condition holds in conformal theory, in particular for the geometric KMS states. What is my recent paper with Stefan Hollands? So the situation, we are in situation. So we have, let's say, in 1+1 dimension. So in space, we have a rod. So here we have some temperature with L. Here some temperature in the air. Here we don't know, it's a probe. Unknown. And let's say we are in the completely rational case just to avoid all technicalities. So we have this one plus one. Then we start at the beginning with a KMS state here at this temperature, a KMS state here at this temperature, but without communication. Then we put in communication. And then a result that after putting in touch the system, the initial space phi converges weakly to a non-equilibrium steady state psi, and we can, I have a formula if you want. So if we evaluate this on the stress energy tensor, and we take the limit as t goes to infinity, then we have pi other 12. The central charge on the left, beta L square minus the central charge, right, R square. Hmm? So this is completely rigorous. I should say that this formula already appeared in a paper by Doran and Bernard, but I think it's very heuristic and at least to me impossible to understand. And we have also a version with the chemical potential where they also have a formula, but there is one term missing there, we call it. But I think it's a very, very clear description of this situation, which is possible by operator algebras. So I think I will stop here.